This channel has been established for visually impaired people. For the visually impaired people, voice narration and a written expression are also provided for the hearing impaired. Don't forget to subscribe to our channel. Frost is the coating or deposit of ice that may form in humid air in cold conditions, usually overnight in temperate climates. It most commonly appears as fragile white crystals or frozen dew drops near the ground, but in cold climates it occurs in a greater variety of forms. Frost is composed of delicate branched patterns of ice crystals formed as the result of fractal process development. Frost is known to damage crops or reduce future crop yields, therefore farmers in those regions where frost is a problem often invest substantial means to prevent its formation. Contents 1. Introduction. 2. Formation. 3. Types. 31. Hoar frost. 32. Advection frost. 33. Window frost. 34. White frost. 35. Rime. 36. Black frost. 4. Effect on plants. 41. Overview. 42. Protection methods. 5. Frost free areas. 6. Personifications. 7. Gallery. 8. See also. 9. References. 10. External links. Introduction. Frost forms when the temperature of a solid surface in the open cools to below the freezing point of water, and for the most clearly crystalline forms of frost in particular, below the frost point in still air. In most temperate countries, such temperatures usually are the result of heat loss by radiation at night, so those types of frost sometimes are called radiation frost. Types of frost include crystalline hoar frost from deposition of water vapor from air of low humidity, white frost in humid conditions, window frost on glass surfaces, advection frost from cold wind over cold surfaces, black frost without visible ice at low temperatures and very low humidity, and rime under super-cooled wet conditions. The size of frost crystals varies depending on the time they have been building up and the amount of water vapor available. Frost crystals may be clear or translucent, but, like snow, a mass of frost crystals will scatter light in all directions, so that a coating of frost appears white. Formation. Frost in the highest town in Venezuela, Apartaderos, because its location in an alpine tundra ecosystem called Paramo, they often undergo a sudden and drastic change in a daily freeze and thaw cycle, sometimes described as summer every day and winter every night. If a solid surface is chilled below the dew point of the surrounding humid air and the surface itself is colder than freezing, ice will form on it. If the water deposits as a liquid that then freezes, it forms a coating that may look glassy, opaque, or crystalline, depending on its type. Depending on context, that process also may be called atmospheric icing. The ice it produces differs in some ways from crystalline frost, which consists of spicules of ice that typically project from the solid surface on which they grow. The main difference between the ice coatings and frost spicules arises from the fact that the crystalline spicules grow directly from desublimation of water vapor from air, and desublimation is not a factor in icing of freezing surfaces. For desublimation to proceed, the surface must be below the frost point of the air, meaning that it is sufficiently cold for ice to form without passing through the liquid phase. The air must be humid, but not sufficiently humid to permit the condensation of liquid water, or icing will result instead of desublimation. The size of the crystals depends largely on the temperature, the amount of water vapor available, and how long they have been growing undisturbed as a rule, except in conditions where super-cooled droplets are present in the air. Frost will form only if the deposition surface is colder than the surrounding air. For instance, frost may be observed around cracks in cold wooden sidewalks when humid air escapes from the warmer ground beneath. Other objects on which frost commonly forms are those with low specific heat or high thermal emissivity, such as blackened metals, hence the accumulation of frost on the heads of rusty nails. The apparently erratic occurrence of frost in adjacent localities is due partly to differences of elevation, the lower areas becoming colder on calm nights where static air settles above an area of ground in the absence of wind. The absorptivity and specific heat of the ground strongly influence the temperature that the trapped air attains. Types. Hoar frost, a spider web covered in air. Hoar frost depth. Hoar, imaged with light and with scanning electron microscopy. Hoar frost, also hoar frost, radiation frost, or pruina, refers to white ice crystals, deposited on the ground or loosely attached to exposed objects such as wires or leaves. They form on cold, clear nights when conditions are such that heat radiates out to the open sky faster than it can be replaced from nearby sources such as wind or warm objects under suitable circumstances. Objects cool to below the frost point of the surrounding air, well below the freezing point of water. Such freezing may be promoted by effects such as flood frost or frost pocket. These occur when ground level radiation losses cool air till it flows downhill and accumulates in pockets of very cold air in valleys and hollows. Hoar frost may freeze in such low-lying cold air even when the air temperature a few feet above ground is well above freezing. The name hoar comes from an Old English adjective that means showing signs of old age. In this context it refers to the frost that makes trees and bushes look like white hair. Hoar frost may have different names depending on where it forms. Air hoar is a deposit of hoar frost on objects above the surface, such as tree branches, plant stems, and wires. Surface hoar refers to fern-like ice crystals directly deposited on snow, ice, or already frozen surfaces. Crevasse hoar consists of crystals that form in glacial crevasses where water vapor can accumulate under calm weather conditions. Depth hoar refers to faceted crystals that have slowly grown large within cavities beneath the surface of banks of dry snow. Depth hoar crystals grow continuously at the expense of neighboring smaller crystals, so typically are visibly stepped and have faceted hollows. When surface hoar covers sloping snowbanks, the layer of frost crystals may create an avalanche risk. When heavy layers of new snow cover the frosty surface, furry crystals standing out from the old snow hold off the falling flakes, forming a layer of voids that prevent the new snow layers from bonding strongly to the old snow beneath. Ideal conditions for hoarfrost to form on snow are cold, clear nights, with very light, cold air currents conveying humidity at the right rate for growth of frost crystals. Wind that is too strong or warm destroys the furry crystals, and thereby may permit a stronger bond between the old and new snow layers. However, if the winds are strong enough and cold enough to lay the crystals flat and dry, carpeting the snow with cold, loose crystals without removing or destroying them or letting them warm up and become sticky, the frost interface between the snow layers still may present an avalanche danger, because the texture of the frost crystals differs from the snow texture and the dry crystals will not stick to fresh snow. Such conditions still prevent a strong bond between the snow layers in very low temperatures where fluffy surface hoar crystals form without subsequently being covered with snow. Strong winds may break them off, forming a dust of ice particles and blowing them over the surface. The ice dust then may form Yukimarimo, as has been observed in parts of Antarctica, in a process similar to the formation of dust bunnies and similar structures. Hoar frost and white frost also occurs in man-made environments such as in freezers or industrial cold storage facilities if such cold spaces or the pipes serving them are not well insulated and are exposed to ambient humidity. The moisture will freeze instantly depending on the freezer temperature. The frost may coat pipes thickly, partly insulating them, but such inefficient insulation still is a source of heat loss. Advection frost: a flower with advection frost on the tips of its petals. Advection frost, also called wind frost, refers to tiny ice spikes that form when there is a very cold wind blowing over branches of trees, poles, and other surfaces. It looks like rimming on the edge of flowers and leaves, and usually it forms against the direction of the wind. It can occur at any hour, day or night. Window frost. Window frost, also called fern frost or ice flowers, forms when a glass pane is exposed to very cold air on the outside and warmer, moderately moist air on the inside. If the pane is not a good insulator, for example, if it is a single pane window, water vapor condenses on the glass forming frost patterns with very low temperatures outside. Frost can appear on the bottom of the window even with double pane energy efficient windows, because the air convection between two panes of glass ensures that the bottom part of the glazing unit is cold colder than the top part. On unheated motor vehicles, the frost will usually form on the outside surface of the glass first. The glass surface influences the shape of crystals, so imperfections, scratches, or dust can modify the way ice nucleates. The patterns in window frost form a fractal with a fractal dimension greater than 1 but less than 2. This is a consequence of the nucleation process being constrained to unfold in two dimensions, unlike a snowflake which is shaped by a similar process but forms in three dimensions and has a fractal dimension greater than 2. If the indoor air is very humid, rather than moderately so, water will first condense in small droplets and then freeze into clear ice. Similar patterns of freezing may occur on other smooth vertical surfaces, but they seldom are as obvious or spectacular as on clear glass. White frost. White frost is a solid deposition of ice which forms directly from water vapor contained in air. White frost forms when there is a relative humidity above 90% and a temperature below -8. Black frost or killing frost is not strictly speaking frost at all, because it is the condition seen in crops when the humidity is too low for frost to form, but the temperature falls so low that plant tissues freeze and die, becoming blackened, hence the term black frost. Black frost often is called killing frost because white frost tends to be less cold, partly because the latent heat of freezing of the water reduces the temperature drop effect on plants. Overview: frost on the grass of a public park in January. Many plants can be damaged or killed by freezing temperatures or frost. This varies with the type of plant, the tissue exposed, and how low temperatures get. A light frost of -2 to 0. Radishes, kale, collard, mustard, turnips, rutabagas. Even those plants that tolerate frost may be damaged once temperatures drop even lower below -4. Protection methods. Curitiba, southern Brazil, is the coldest of Brazil's state capitals. The greenhouse of the Botanical Garden of Curitiba protects sensitive plants. Typical measures to prevent frost or reduce its severity include one or more of deploying powerful blowers to simulate wind, thereby preventing the formation of accumulations of cold air. There are variations on this theme. One of them is the selective inverted sink prevents frost by drawing cold air from the ground and blowing it up through a chimney. It was originally developed to prevent frost damage to citrus fruits in Uruguay and New Zealand. Helicopters are used in a similar function, especially in the vineyard regions like Marlborough, by dragging down warmer air from the inversion layers, and preventing the ponding of colder air on the ground. The low-flying helicopters prevent damage to the fruit buds as the operations are conducted at night, and have in the past involved up to 130 aircraft per night in one region. Safety rules are strict, although not a dedicated method. Wind turbines have similar small effect of vertically mixing air layers of different temperature for high-value crops. Farmers may wrap trees and cover crops heating to slow the drop in temperature. This is not practical except for high-value crops grown over small areas. Production of smoke to reduce cooling by radiation spraying crops with a layer of water that releases latent heat, preventing harmful freezing of the tissues of the plants that it coats. Such measures need to be applied with discretion, because they may do more harm than good. For example, spraying crops with water can cause damage if the plants become overburdened with ice. An effective low-cost method for small crop farms and plant nurseries exploits the latent heat of freezing. A pulsed irrigation timer delivers water through existing overhead sprinklers at a low volumes to combat frosts down to -5. Personifications. Further information: Dead Moroz and Father Frost. Fairy tale Frost is personified in Russian culture as Dead Moroz. Indigenous peoples of Russia, such as the Mordvins, have their own traditions of frost deities. English folklore tradition holds that Jack Frost, an elfish creature, is responsible for feathery patterns of frost found on windows on cold mornings. Gallery Frost air hoar on pine branches. Frost on a nettle. Rime frost large feathery crystals. Hoar frost melting on grass in France. Frost on branches. Image made using infrared photography techniques. Fern frost on a window. Frost on plant leaves in the Himalayas. Surface hoar in Alaska. Hoar frost crystals on fence in central Oregon, USA. Bow River ice fog and hoar frost on north shore of Bow River, Calgary, Alberta at -20. ISBN. Karat Klazinska, Ursula, et al. 27 February 2014, Low Temperature Seed Germination of Cucumber, Genetic Basis of the Tolerance Trait, Journal of Horticultural Research, De Gruyter, 21-2, doi.102478, jar 2013-0031, retrieved 28 February 2014. 107 No. 42, October 19, 2010, p. 17899. Carat Wind Farms Impacting Weather, Science Daily. Carat AB, A Practical Method of Frost Protection, retrieved 31 October 2011. The Solid State of Water. Crystalline Types IHIC23IVVV78XX11121314 15. 16 Formations and Phenomena. Amorphous solid anchor black clathrate hydrates cap cave circle or disc crystals dam. Frazil frost frost he frost flower. Rime hard soft sea slurry slush storm ice related activities. Bathing blasting blocking climbing fishing rafting sculpture skating sports. Boating. Pick trade other uses chips core cream cube pack ice ages glaciology little ice age Pleistocene.